Hello folks, and welcome to the Great Outdoors RV Company. My name is Octavio. Around here they call me Oc. Today we are looking at the 2018 8326BHS, which means bunkhouse, outside kitchen, front queen bedroom, sleeps 10 people comfortably. Check this one out, guys. I think you're gonna like it. All right, folks, let's go over weights real quick here. So the dry weight on this is 8,554 pounds. The total GVWR on this is 10,883 pounds, giving you about 2,300 pounds of cargo capacity that you can carry on this coach. So the length on this is 35 feet, 11 inches, and this is 11 foot on the height. Now I would add about 6 to 7 inches more of that for your AC and your vents and stuff that you have on the roof. But overall height is about 11 to 12 feet. So one of the big perks or options that this trailer has is the outside kitchen. So on top of you having this sleep capacity of 10 people, you also have the capacity to cook for 10 people, right? So here you have a two burner stove, cooktop on your outside kitchen, of course. Small little fridge, I guess ideal for those adult beverages, maybe a bunch of sodas and stuff, a little bit of a nice option up here. Storage, right? One of the big things that campers need when you're camping is plenty of storage. So bread, chips, and all that would be fitting in here nicely. Now they do this in the metal because of the weathering reasons. You want stuff to last quite a bit of longer than if it were like a wood product exposed to the elements. Metal does better. If you keep on coming this way, you will notice a couple of things going on here. So aside from your two burner stove, you have a gas grill that this comes with. You have two 30 pound liquid propane bottles that are located on the front with a quick disconnect here. Now this can also be an option that you go to Home Depot and you get the little adapters. So if you have the Coleman gas grill or something bigger that you haul along with you to do a lot of more cooking, this is good. It's a good option because then you don't have to lug a big tank around here or anything like that. You use your quick connects. So just, I can't get the awning out completely all the way, but as you can see, you have a pretty large awning. Now it does have the metal wrap over that first foot or so. Now that'll take care of any sun, rot, or weathering that may happen. Makes your awning last that much longer. If you take a look again, you have that LED strip for the full length of it. That really illuminates this area here. I mean, if you're cooking out here and you're hanging out here towards the night, then you can really depend on being it a little bit more illuminated. This is a nice little spot for your TV, and I'll kind of show a little picture of that. You also have a 110 outlet here and a cable satellite port, which is also connected to your antenna. So that's gonna actually give you a little bit more of those digital signals for that TV. If you move on this way, we're gonna have a 6 gallon gas electric water heater here. Now this will do 16.2 gallons when you run it on electric and gas at the same time. That switch is also inside, so that's why they call it DSI, direct spark ignition. One of the fancier thing that's going on with these coaches is they're adding these Moride solid steps. Now these are supported on the floor, and as you can see, I mean, I'm 200 and change and this thing is not moving. You know, you can come up here with a bunch of waters or a bunch of stuff, and you don't have to worry about the whole coach rocking or it being unstable for those weak knees. This thing does its job. And when it's time to get put away, go ahead and swing this up. Look at the effort on that. Put this away like so, and it gets it out of the road, you know. No grime, no rust, no more pinching your fingers. Up and away and it's gone. Keep it clean. Yep. So that makes it that much easier. ROCKWOOD does a really good job at implementing systems for those RVers who need that extra little bit of help and who don't want to struggle when they're camping. They just want a vacation, right? So this is a fully aluminum structure with vacuum bonded walls. What that means for you is that this coach is going to last for many years to come. The construction, the insulation on this is top notch. Rockwood is amongst one of the top sellers for travel trailers in the world because, of course, they're the best in the US. So if you come in here, you're going to see the aluminum structure that I was referring to. Now they'll do their dinette like that. They'll do the couches like that. The framing on the roof and on the floor and in the walls are like that. And it's just top quality stuff. This is gonna be a pass-through storage. Slam latch doors on this, metal, of course. And they do the magnets this year. So no more clips that weather over time. It's just a little more user-friendly. Once you get to your campsite and you level this coach out, you're gonna wanna stabilize it. So you have 4-point auto stabilizers here. Push the buttons, those drops down. They keep that sway from happening when the shift is when the weight is shifting in the coach. No more rocking or anything like that. Moving on to the front here, this is a rougher bottom. So they're not doing the diamond plate, they're just doing a front cap with that's a lot more higher durability. This is where the rocks hit when you're driving down the road. Here you have automotive frameless glass. This is the kind of windshield that you have on your on the front of your vehicle. So it's top quality stuff. You have two 30-pound liquid propane bottles here with the auto changeover regulator. A smart jack, this will remember the hitch height of your truck, and it'll also do an auto retract option. So that's pretty cool. Some space for two batteries in the back over here. On a coach this size, I would consider two batteries. It's always a good option to have that extra juice, just in case you're doing a lot more of that dry camping and not hooked up all the time. All right, folks, so this is gonna be the driver's side of the coach. You have three slides here. This is a wardrobe slide. This is your kitchen, living room, dinette slide. A little bit of storage under the dinette, and once again, that whole thing is framed out in aluminum. And here you have a little bit of a light, nice little area. I guess you could almost do a shower curtain here. You have a hot and cold shower located on the back here, rinsing the feet off, rinsing the pets off. Could almost take a quick little shower in here if that isn't a problem at your campground. Down here is a little hookup port. So it has its little door. It has a tank flush in the black tank. It has sprayers. You hook up a hose there, flushes everything, all that waste out. Here you have a city inlet. So you can hook up a hose here and your camper would run off of city pressure. Or you have the option also to switch this over, put this into a 5-gallon jug of antifreeze and winterize your coach. So it's nice that they don't put that in the back of the water heater, for example. It's easy to get to, very user friendly. 50 amp service for the 2 AC option that we have. I think this only comes with one. And then you have the cable satellite option also. All right, folks, here we are on the rear of the coach. If you look up here, you have a wire prep for a Furion backup camera. Now, we sell those in our parts store. We also have the observational kind that can give you the ability to constantly be looking behind you, not only when you're backing up. Hard shell for your spare tire, potable water if you want to fill your fresh tank, LED stop lights, LEDs on the inside throughout the whole coach, and I'll show you that here in a second. Rear ladder, so you can get up there, check those seals. It's always a good idea once a year or so. You want to make sure your roof hasn't ripped or if your seals aren't giving way due to weathering. You also have a little nice option here on the bumper for your sewer hose. Just a nice little option. You don't want to put that sewer hose where you're storing all your food under your carriage or something like that. So this is a nice little option. So how about we go inside and we finish up this tour, huh? Alrighty, folks, come on inside and take a look in here because there's plenty to look at. Rockwood, with their wood construction, the way they do their wood work is very nice. On these signatures, you're looking at hidden hinges, all solid wood with the raised panel cabinetry. We optioned the refrigerator with the nice panels too. The signatures are doing the 50-50 stainless steel split in the kitchen. You have a nice three burner cooktop here with the glass top option. Also acts like a backsplash. 22 inch oven, so that's a little bit bigger than what the competition has. Please compare. Here you have a hood that's also vented outside. You got a light, a microwave, of course, for the popcorn and the piece of pizza. And overall, a pretty good look. This is a gas electric refrigerator. So So it runs on one or the other. It'll do an auto changeover. And this is a 10,000 gallon water filtration system that this has. So all the coach that's either in your tank or being plumbed in for example, your city connection is getting filtered. So that's always a good thing. You're taking shower in it, you're washing your hands in it, and it's all clean. Entertainment. Here we have an IRV's Technologies stereo DVD player, has the HDMI port, has a USB port, has an auxiliary in port. I can hook up my phone to this and do some Bluetooth, collect volume, channels, etc. Nice little TV on a swing arm. This guy comes out, you know, you got your couch and your dinette on that side, so it's always a good option to be able to not crank your neck too much and kind of face it that way. It's a pretty nice, decent-sized TV. It's a Toshiba. You have a sound bar down here, so it great sound. I mean, when this is on, you can. They've tested these, and that's why they went from the speakers that you had on the ceiling over to the sound bar. Alrighty, folks. So I did say this coach sleeps a lot of people. We're estimating about 10, but it really depends on the size of folks. I mean, you can cram little kids up pretty tight, right? Like sardines. if you wanted to use this as a bed, you remove these two cushions here, and this pulls on up. So you got the double legs down here, fold those out, and this comes down like so. Now I'm about 5'7", so, you know, me by myself, maybe with the wife, I could sleep comfortably. I might hang off a little bit, but I'm not the tallest of the guys. Maybe a taller gentleman might have problems and we can put him in the bunk room or something like that, or this U-shaped dinette. So let me show you how this breaks down, okay? All right, folks, so check this out. We got some magic going on here. This turns into a bed too. Let me show you how that works. And just like that, it's magic, right? I mean, you clap your hands and it happens. I'm just kidding, folks. That little bit of movie magic, but this is what the bed position looks like. So you can actually remove these cushions a little bit more to give you that extra 4 inches or so of height. I mean, a 6'2", 6'4" guy can fit on this no problem. Now, to put this up, it's pretty easy. Put the cushions back where they go. On the table here, you got this mechanism that kinda comes out like so, and there you go. I mean, you could use this to put this in the kitchen for a little more counter space, or you could take it outside and put it under that awning for a nice little barbecue. So we have a front master bedroom in this. If you come over this way, you have two pocket doors that gives you access to it, and you have a queen size bed. Now this is pretty high quality Denver mattress. It's nice to have a good quality mattress to start your coach off with, brand new of course. Here you have a wardrobe slide with hanging closet room. And then on this side, you have more for maybe towels or more clothes. It's just ample room. I wanna say that's about 1.5 feet deep. On the top of your bed here, you also have more storage. And this is high. It's not a head knocker, so you don't have to worry about you getting up hastily in the morning, or, you know, half asleep in the morning and banging your head on this. Not a problem. Individual touch lights here. You have 110 connections and USB charging port on that side with a little more drawer space. On the front here, you can notice a window with the blackout shades, the day shades, and of course you can open this up. Kind of nice that it's tinted to where you can see outside but without a lot of people necessarily being able to see inside. Now this is prepped for a second AC, so that vent would be where the AC drops in, and it would be ducted, of course. Moving on back this way. All right, guys, let's take a look at this bathroom here. It's not the biggest bathroom in the world, but it has all its amenities, and they are upgraded amenities. Medicine cabinet, max air fan, you have the neo-angled shower with the glass enclosure there. Commode is gonna be porcelain, ducted heat, ducted AC, and you know, this is pretty ample space. I'm 5'7", I've seen 6'2 guys, 6'4 guys, plenty of headroom. These are magnetically shut, keeps the soap water in. I got room to move my elbows around. You know, it's not, I could rinse off, lather, and everything comfortably in here. room for your toiletries, room for your soap. That's a stone casted sink. So say you're doing your curling iron or something like that and it falls in the sink and it was plastic, that wouldn't be good. But that stone cast should withstand the heat. Alrighty folks, so if you're dealing temperature, you have your RV comfort thermostat here. This controls your air conditioner, which has a quick cool feature. Open these vents out and they will dump all the cold air here. Usually want to start off your AC like that, and then once your temperature gets about right, close these up and you force the air out to the ducts. Now the important thing about the ceiling here is that you have all LED lights. Now benefit of LED lights is they're easier on your battery, uses less power, and they also create less heat. So they're not fighting that air conditioner, which is a pretty good option when you're thinking about a coach this size and you're trying to keep it cool. Okay. All right, folks. So before we go into the bunk room, I want to show you a little closet space, of course. This has hanging room. You can pull these drawers out and it becomes a hanging, or you leave these shelves in and you can use them for more pantry space, for example, or towels and stuff since you are next to the bathroom. And here we have the last but not least, the bunk room. So if you're looking for plenty of space, you know, some space to keep the kids out because it's raining or something, or you want to do a cot or two, or one of those baby cribs that folks of mine had some ideas like that earlier, this is the place. So this is a bunk room, TV backer here, plenty of storage everywhere. Rockwood will try and they'll give it to you, and they'll give it to you right with a good quality wood. Here's a ladder for either side. I can go ahead and knock this down on gas pistons and have access that way. This couch turns into a bed just like the one in the front that I showed you. So about queen size, comes about to here. On this side, you have a little seat. So you can do your shoes, you can hang out, you can watch TV, or when it's time for bed, pull this little latch here, remove this cushion, and you have an extra bunk. So let's talk about sleeping space. You got two people on the queen bed in the front. You have a single here, two people on here, a single up there. You have your U-shape that turns into a bed, and the queen couch that also turns into a bed. So that's like about 10 people of sleeping capacity. This is the coach if you're taking a lot of people with you. All right, folks, so what did you think? What do you think about that bunkhouse, the outside kitchen? Is the front bedroom big enough for you? Tell me what you think in the comments below. This was the 2018 8326 BHS. Now we have one in stock. We have a couple like this in stock, a couple different floor plans. Check out our website, www.thegreatoutdoorsrv.com. You can also ask us a question through email, sales@thegreatoutdoorsrv.com, or just pick up the phone. We have plenty of people that can answer and help you with your questions. Full parts and service department, 970-313-4337. Thank you very much. My name is Octavio. Around here they call me Oc, and thank you very much for your time.